So I listened to the Lotus Flower album yesterday, and I definitely, you know, thoroughly enjoyed it. I thought every track on that album was very well executed. There weren't any, like, or I don't really recall any tracks that really, like, blew me away or anything. But, or, actually, I don't know. I'm gonna have to re-listen to it. I haven't re-listened to it yet. But I definitely don't recall, like, any tracks, you know, being, like, bad or unlistenable or anything like that. So, yeah, I thought it was a very well-executed album. I love the overall just psychedelic feel of the album. Like, every kind of track had that undertone of, like, a psychedelic feel. And also, like, the heavy rock implementation throughout this album was definitely noticeable as well. I feel like this is probably, like, one of his, like, you know, more original albums. Like, this felt like a true, just like, you know, Prince album, instead of, you know, him trying to modernize and whatnot with the times. It really felt like just, you know, something that came straight out of his head and right on wax, you know. But yeah, I thought this was a great album. A lot of great songs. The overall vibe of it was real nice. Oh yeah, that was one song I wasn't really a huge fan of. I forgot which one it was, but it was like him doing the auto-tune thing, and yeah, I'm not a big fan of auto-tune. But I think overall the album was definitely, you know, very unique, and also, like, at the same time, it had like this nostalgic feel, like a lot of the songs, like, it, you know, sounded like I was listening to 80s Prince or something, you know, like it had that, like, nostalgic feel to it. And I loved it, man. I absolutely loved it. I feel like the closest thing, like, if you were to compare this album to another one, it would probably be Purple Rain, because of, like, that heavy rock implementation throughout this album, even though I still feel like, you know, it's two different, you know, albums completely. But if I had to compare it to the album, I feel like that would be the closest comparison. And that's a good thing, you know? That's a very good thing. But yeah, this was a real good album. Really enjoyed it. And yeah, definitely excited to check out the MPL Sound album as well. Oh yeah, and I tried looking for this digital edition of this song right here. And I could not find it anywhere. So, I mean, I found one version, but it looked like it wasn't probably gonna, I don't know. I guess I'll just listen to it, but I did find one video on it, but it wasn't like an official, you know, thing or anything, so I was kind of like, eh. But, yeah, pretty excited to check out this MPL Sound album. Probably about to do that, like, in a few minutes, if I'm being honest. But, anything else? I don't know, this album just felt, I guess to reiterate, just felt very, very, very original. You know, like, I can't really recall, like, another album that even comes close to this that he's done, you know? Whereas, you know, a lot of his albums, you know, I mean, don't really sound too similar, but, like, some of his more recent ones don't really have, like, any type of crazy distinction. So the fact that he did this and just, you know, kind of did something wild and random, I don't know, I like it. But yeah, that was the Lotus Flower album. Definitely enjoyed it, and if you guys enjoyed the reaction, make sure you smack the like button, subscribe if you're new. That being said, much love, stay safe, and peace out.